not too distant future, next Sunday AD, there was a guy named Joel, not too different from you or me. He worked at Gizmonic Institute, just another face in a red jumpsuit. He did a good job cleaning up the place, but his boss didn't like him, so they shot him into space. We'll send the cheesy movies, the worst we can find. He'll have to sit and watch them all, then we'll monitor his mind. Now keep in mind, Joel can't control where the movies begin or end, because he used those special parts to make his robot friends.
Robot, we'll call Cabot, Gypsy, Tom Servo, Crow.
You're wondering how he eats and breathes and other science facts, then repeat to yourself, it's just the show. I should really just relax.
And God bless Joel and Gypsy.
And all the aliens that have visited the ship.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to Satellite Love. When you've got a job like ours, you have to believe in a higher power.
30 seconds to commercial sign.
And God bless Data and his really cool robot named Lol.
And R2-D2 and all the extras in Westworld.
And RoboCop, even though I thought he got a raw deal, but it's really none of my business. Oh, and all those early versions that were just there for comic relief.
And Ed-209, though I don't know why they'd make a robot that can't walk downstairs.
And God bless Cherry 3000.
Oh, yeah, and God bless Galaxina.
Okay, and who else?
Do we have to?
I don't want to. I'm not.
Yeah, you have to.
Okay.
God bless Tweety.
Commercial sign in 5, 4, 3, 2. Commercial sign now.
Amen. Come on, we have to pray for them. If we can pray for them, we can pray for anybody.
I don't want to pray for the mad scientist.
Yeah, Joel, why do we have to pray for them?
Well, I think they're watching and they control my oxygen.
We don't want you to pray for us. We want you to pray to us. Isn't that right, Frank?
Don't look at me! I said never look at me! Mommy! Mommy!
Frank, calm down. It's time for the invention exchange again, Joel, and we'll go first because we've got a party to go to later. Well, this summer's fashions cry out with jubilant 2-inch armor plating, saucy turrets, and shells aplenty. Can really clear the beaches this summer with our new tank tops.
That's right. The best beach party ever was the one at Normandy. Beach blanket bingo is now beach blanket bombing with the latest in fashion artillery.
That's right. Shelling on the beach takes on a whole new meaning. Let's get in position, Frank. Ready, aim, fire. Now let's see how we've done.
Hey, wait a minute. I can hear the war.
Oh, knock that off.
Oh,
now look at here. Look, there's still a little red. I'm sorry, I can't give you the bear. Well, what do you think, Joel?
Boy, we sure think differently, thank goodness, you know. You know, you guys took something fun and made it evil, whereas I took something evil and I'm making it fun. Check it out, it's the Tickle Bazooka, all right? It's for those times when just a normal tickle isn't enough. I based it on the premise of what the pundits, Firesign Theater, once spoke. Fighting's out of style, fun's where the fear is. See, it's got a feather bayonet for hand-to-hand tickling.
Okay.
And then if you really want to have some big blast of ballistic hilarity, there's the mirth mortar. Let me show you.
Uh-oh. Where's
yourself?
Head for cover.
Smile. What do you think?
That is so neat. We could base a whole party around that. We could all get in our fuzzy feety pajamas and jump up and down on the bed.
Look, the only party we're going to is the one where we dance on your grave.
Oh, will I be invited?
You'll be the guest of honor. Now, tell them about the movie. I gotta get out of this thing. I'm chafing like a bear.
Well, Joel, this week's movie is called Catalina Caper, and it is delightful. It's a veritable feel-good movie, a lighthearted romp, a triumph of the human spirit. Thank you, Tommy Kirk, for making us laugh about love. Again. And it's got a great theme song. You're gonna love it. Never, ever,
Frank!
Ever see anything.
That was funny. Oh, fun.
That was yep. fun.
Huh.
Great fun.
What gives? Interesting. What's wrong with this guy's feet?
He has prehensile toes.
What do you suppose frogmen's legs taste like?
Like San Diego chicken legs, probably.
So, what's in the can?
I think it's dehydrated water.
Oh.
Oh, a scuba film.
Jacques Cousteau meets the Pink Panther.
By this time, my...
Hey, come on. Just,
huh?
No, just lay okay. off. Okay.
So right. What's a Catalina caper?
It's one of those little balls you find when you're eating peel and eat shrimp.
Sorry, Charlie, only the best titles are picked.
Starring Tommy Kirk, why must Spock die?
You may steal his heart. Oh, Robert Donner. I went to his party.
Gee, I wonder what she's harping on about.
Hey, who's this guy? Jim Begg, Sue Casey, Lyle Wagner, Mike Bludgeon.
Nice measurements. 36-285?
I think that fish is gonna spit up again.
Who's afraid of Vanita Wolf anyway?
Charlie, they cut off my thumbs.
Special guest star Peter Mamakos.
Oh, Little Richard. I've heard of him. He's not as famous as Peter Mamakos.
Oh, he's playing a trick on that fish. Oh, yeah, feel good about kicking a fish's butt. That's real nice.
Screenplay written in crayon.
What's Clydeware?
Sal Mungio, Rebel Without a Gauze.
It's like the Bullwinkle Show, doesn't it?
Yeah. Here's something you really like.
Shalom!
Look out!
Wow, that is really good animation.
Now I'll set fire to the Walt Whitman books, then I'll burn the pile of Catcher in the Rye.
Come on, you ho daddies, let's burn some books.
Yoo-hoo!
Burn the witch, burn the witch. We shall cleanse the earth with fire.
Well, these clan meetings have really lightened up. Look at that.
Now that's what I call art. Scantily clad women and a Huey Lewis News sound on the radio. This is the kind of padding I like to see in a film.
Throw another Beach Boy on the fire. Whoa.
And so the white Aryan youth dance around the funeral pyre.
You know, this is really good sound, and it was before Dolby.
Dolby Gillis? I don't know.
Meanwhile, in the dark, impenetrable void, Jean-Paul Sartre was a-movin' and a-groovin'.
No exit, baby.
Oh, looks like they're in the night gallery.
This portrait, a man who smokes more than Edward R. Murrow or Lillian Hellman.
I'm William Conrad for First Alert. When you're heading down to the refrigerator and the power goes out...
Yeah, it's Steve Higgins.
Oh, you mean the star of the Higgins Boys and Gruber
yeah.
is seen on the comedy channel?
Yeah.
Wow.
This must be Tommy Kirk's Oscar. He's so good that they gave it to him before they started the film. He beat out Troy Donahue and Frankie Avalon.
Huh?
Hey, I beat out Dom DeLuise and James Coco for this role. Now beat it.
He's looking for that string quartet.
An original Red Skelton. That's incredibly valuable.
Good night, may God bless. This painting is blue. Don't work blue with such a waste.
I'm gonna put this in a frame that fits.
Gee, it looks like a garage rag.
Sim security. I'm the one who cracked that crime at One Potato Too. I beat out Al Molinaro and Jesse White for this role.
Oh, that's a family circus. Looks, from Hank looks, Ketchum's Bill Keane collection.
Looks kind of like a Reuben.
Paul Reuben? You mean Pee Wee Herman?
No.
Oops, he broke Tommy's Oscar. Well, I did the same thing to his Pulitzer.
Huh? What?
He's putting it together.
Oh, relax. They'll just think it's a Rothko now, see?
Yeah, Mondrian, perhaps.
Boy, that's a big whistle. You know how to whistle, don't you? You just put your lips together and cut to the boat.
Bangkok, Oriental City.
Koyana Scotsi. Life out of balance.
You know, this film is a fantasy because you generally don't see cabs in Southern California like this.
America's fastidious and well-groomed youth living a clean lifestyle, pumping their clean, hard-won dollars into a clean economy that is sunny, colorful, Catalina.
Fire Island? Hey, look at this. White people voted the best people in the world.
Young white male still on top.
NEA denies Bill Keane grant.
Oh, it looks like Brutus and Popeye after Slim Fast.
Yeah, Olive standing right behind him.
Not bad.
What's that supposed to mean?
I'm going on board, Bob.
I know. I can see it in your eyes.
Mother! Charlie, baby's come back to the nest. Welcome home, delinquent.
Oh, thanks, but we're felons now.
Hi, I'm Bob Draper. School must have assigned you as keeper. Don Pringle.
Heir to the potato chip fortune.
Never seen the big water before. I figured a summer on the island put a little juice in the old battery. I think you'll like it if you can take him. I did. You should have seen him coming up the coast. I don't think they sell bikinis in Arizona. Well, they sell them, but I never saw so many trying to cover so much with so little success.
Thank you, Winston Churchill.
I felt the same way myself. It only gets better.
Say.
Talk about discouraged. Have you seen the new crop?
And my corn is as high as an elephant's eye.
Decisions. I've seen three exactly my type.
Yeah, real dog.
Look, somebody stole another painting.
Final boarding whistle. Yeah, we'll dig you later. I'll be around, if only to keep you guys out of trouble.
I love this good-natured ribbing.
Well, what do you suppose this guy's up to?
I don't believe it.
You saw Big Jake.
Here, let me help you up with that. Say, that gangplank really gave you what for, friend. He should wear a truss.
Cue the made-for-TV music. Love, exciting, and new.
Duh.
Smell that air, huh? Take a look around. Mm.
Air, water, you're pretty observant there, pal.
It's far more exhilarating to virgin below deck.
I didn't know you were holding, my compadre.
Maybe you're not ready. I'm ready.
I think the forum will be good for me.
I plan the agenda. In Phoenix, you showed me all the ugly glories of Gila monsters and cactus and pants. I'm Catalina. Believe it, man, I am king. Surfing. Girl. Big game fishing. Girl. Scuba diving.
Guys.
Girl. He sounds like Kirk Gowdy, doesn't he?
Or Hugh Hefner.
I'm in your capable hand. All right, and we start the summer with a bang, like we start right now, below deck.
You mean deck?
Said
well,
deck,
he breathes
huh?
a bit. I've been driving all night. Breathe, live, if Mohammed won't come to the mountain.
Well, I think that's inappropriate social behavior.
Excuse me, I gotta go invent the Walkman. After this.
And so I want to join the forum.
Hey, nice railing.
May I retie your pants?
It was quiet out here.
It was quiet.
What an idiot.
I've never seen the ocean before.
Oh, then you've missed much.
Yes, it's only 75% of the Earth's surface.
Yes, I have.
There is a whole world beneath all that. And there is life. All sizes, shapes, and colors.
Gifts.
Huh? Sure could get hung up on it tomorrow night on the beach.
Yes, I'm hung up on it right now. Help me.
I dove into the sea and began swimming underwater. And there was this small fish.
She's beautiful,
Joel. He wasn't afraid of me at all.
Hey, was she in the movie David and Lisa?
I think she's pretty.
Fishing boat ahead frightened. And I never saw my little friend again.
You know, there's a psychiatrist on board. I think he could really help you.
For the weekend. Perhaps longer. Why?
Great. Because would you like to go swimming with me?
With me and Edie Sedgwick and Rod LaRod?
Oh, that would be wonderful, but I'm afraid that...
Don, baby. Go
get him. Say.
Hey, we're done with the forum. We're druids now.
I'm the truth. I can't help whatever it is I do to him. Come on.
Ooh. I'd like to make their scene, but they're a little weird and... Hey, fishy, fishy, fishy. Come here, little fishy,
hey,
fishy.
Let's dig Little Richard and really turn it on.
Little Richard? I hate impressionists.
Oh, you're thinking of Rich Little.
Oh.
Now pay attention, guys. This scene is obviously really important to the film.
This is Little Richard.
Uh-oh.
Dig it. Prince, I hope you're watching this.
Hey, we have a chair downstairs with that upholstery.
It looks like a coffin lining.
Hey, get the funk out of my face. Come on.
Dig it.
Wow, there's really nothing we can say about that, is there?
At least not during family hour.
Hey, look, it's Alan Seuss.
Oh.
Oops. It's getting seasick. I think I know a bright young singer that's hopped up on goofballs right now.
Is he in this scene?
Yes. And his head's about 10 feet tall.
Huge. I like the Pendleton mustache.
Okay. Hey, that's his band.
Great. Next, we'll see Sly Stone with the Up With People problem.
Ike Turner with the Cow Sills. They'll all be in casts.
James Brown and the Starland Vocal Band.
Yeah, maybe. George Clinton with the Ray Conniff Singers.
Like this, Mr. Richard? How's this, huh?
Is there a history of epilepsy in your family, boy?
You know, he's so hopped up. I think he's thinking he's at the Apollo or something.
I like him. Hey, it's Ron Howard's brother.
Ben.
Hey, whoa. Looks like Cousin It with a bob.
A swinging bob. Mm-hmm. Little Richard, the only genuine talent in this film.
You know, those dancers are standing on dumpsters. Would that make them white trash?
I'm glad we recycle.
The Nazi party! Everybody!
You know, I'm feeling like we were at the dance thing and laughing, kind of.
Oh, well, you were great. Now leave. Out the back door.
Well, it's just us, Timmy. When you graduate from Pat Boone University.
So Falco leaves the Calypso. And another painting is stolen.
Oh, is this where they filmed the boat next? That looks really familiar.
My skull is an amplifier. Yeah, I did it. I did it. I'm proud, man.
Hey, you got puke on my radio.
Oh, you got radio on my puke. Actually, I think he's working on a new script.
It must be the screenwriter.
Yeah.
Make a...
Oh, magic balcony, take me away from this kooky crowd.
I'm the white guy who runs this ship. I could take out this whole crowd if I wanted to. I'm that powerful. Disperse!
It's time to vacuum the pool, I think.
Hey, you got room for one more extra? Wait for me.
Oh, they've got a fat dumpy guy in this already.
Oh, sorry.
They're diving for chum.
Got it!
Got it! Whoa. Got it now! Jump him up!
Petticoat Junction!
Yeah, what gives? He's the guy with the implant.
Carol? 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 Hey, Carol?
Harvey?
Carol?
How's your little fish?
We have a proper love.
I got your stick, Mr. Luthor.
Oh.
Oh, would you give me that?
Sorry. Man, I'm too tired to even do one of my famous pratfalls.
I'm all hurting and hot and hurting stuff.
Well, now, guys, just sit right back and you'll hear a tale.
Crete, ancient civilization.
Mykonos, modern civilization.
Mel Brooks, Anne Bancroft, and Dom DeLuise in Boatniks 2.
Oh, shut up.
Village idiot.
I do the best I can with what I've got.
Which isn't a whole hell of a lot.
Let's go downstairs and I'll show.
Cat is below.
I'm afraid our son wouldn't approve of
our... Your son? What is this? Who's afraid of Virginia Woolf?
I know what you mean.
It's not your son,
you
George.
You just can't trust a kid who don't follow baseball.
Or trust a guy with a dumb Crayola hat. Yeah. Hey, it's filled with M&Ms.
Neat.
Long ones.
Well, let's see here. You are a child of the universe, no less than the trees and...
That's Desiderata.
What do you think, Ed?
It's a Howard Johnson placemat. I don't think you won the riddle contest.
With the equipment we had below, it shouldn't take long.
Say.
I should have the duplicate finished in less than 24 hours.
She's something.
We're a great little team.
Oh, shut up.
Yeah, not enough for an infield, but it's the William Burroughs figurehead.
Even they make me sick.
Hey, why two? One for the genuine, one for the duplicate.
One for the little girl who lives down the lane.
Jodie Foster?
Yeah.
Now we know the entire plot. Thanks a lot.
Hey, have you contacted our fat Greek pigeon yet?
Bryn
Lakopoulos arrived
last night. He's the Topolis.
You know, I hear he's got a whole castle filled with stolen art treasure stashed away in Switzerland.
Nerds Popolis.
How come a millionaire like Dino Lakopoulos wants to be a crook?
Because he's unscrupulous.
One needs a profession to procure one's taste, Lawrence. Oh, I see.
First, can I light that for you?
He okays it, right? Right.
Right.
Then we slip him the phony scroll that you're going to paint tonight.
Then
Donald goes in where the others have been.
Then you'll return the original to its rightful owner.
Uh-huh. And then return that shirt to Robin Williams.
I mean, how come we can't keep it?
We certainly can't keep it. That would be dishonest.
Oh.
Well, the deal we're pulling on Lakopoulos ain't exactly kosher.
Oh, well, hold the mail.
Not quite the same. Lakopoulos is a proud thief. That's the only way he'll do business. It's expected one will try to cheat him.
Like Nixon.
Arthur, you've outdone yourself this time. Why, you're simply glowing with humility.
That's sweat.
Ah, oh, dear, I'm really very proud of you.
Thank you, dearest. I must admit, I do have a flair for this sort of thing.
Alcoholism?
True.
Bet he won't fall.
Oh. Well, we better beat it, guys.
Oh, yeah.
Beat water. Head to gasoline.
That kills me.
Joel, could you tell us about this thing called the 60s?
Yeah, I'm amused and fascinated by such an environment that the beautiful, creepy girl existed in.
Well, I was just a little kid when it happened, but I could tell you guys what I remember.
Okay.
Well, yeah, you're so much older than you're younger than that now.
Yeah, whatever, Crow. Anyway, Kamba, could you run that music? Yeah, cool. Hey. Okay. Well, it was a lot simpler time back then, you know? Like, I'll give you an example. Like, it wasn't uncommon at all for your mom to come and serve you a great big char-broiled steak while she smoked and drank a tab and made your dad another Manhattan for the road, and that was just breakfast.
Oh, go on.
Yeah, there were seatbelts in cars, but nobody used them. Pre-sweetened cereal, subliminal messages.
Drugs.
People smoked openly on The Tonight Show.
Hey, tell us about the Rat Pack again.
Oh, okay. Well, as you know, Frank Sinatra was chairman of the board, and everybody else filed on in line, except for Jerry Lewis. He had had a falling out with Dean Martin, and they already had chosen Joey Bishop to be their comic relief already, so he was kind of out of luck. But Dean was tall and tan and quick with a song, and he just had to say the word, and cuckoo chicks would file on up to the hospitality suite and massage Peter Lawford's neck and make everybody groovy drinks while they took important phone calls from places like Palm Springs and the White House until it was time for Frank Sinatra, the chairman of the board, to come out of the sauna, and he'd say the words and the dollies would go take a nap.
Subliminal messages. Oh, tell us about the rabbits, Joel.
Yeah, that's
the rabbits,
a good one.
Okay. Meanwhile, in the Windy City, Hugh Hefner was cooking up his own groovy scene in the aptly named Playboy Mansion.
Oh, wow.
Okay, there was George Kennedy and George Hamilton and Tony Curtis and Bill Bixby were all in his court. Sophisticated men who knew their racket.
I think you're swinging into high.
Yeah,
anyway, there was like Twiggy and Abby and Peter, Paul and Mary, Dion, Donovan, Melanie, Abraham, Martin, and John.
So they just went by their first names like that?
Yeah, like you, Crow.
Hey.
And there were typewriters, but nobody used them. And women were called girls.
Wow,
and businessmen wore double-breasted suits, had double chins, drank double bourbon, straight no chaser. Before, during, and after
Peter
important
Max.
Business meetings and summit talks. Everybody
I'm
believed
walrus.
What the president said. Why shouldn't they?
Sitting.
Sexually provocative humor wasn't on TV. It was on cocktail napkins, and we liked it that way. Toys had metal edges and little pieces that were breakable and would fit into your mouth. They would take and make a playground equipment out of stainless steel then haul it up on the asphalt where you could get hurt. Parents were actually told to spank their kids. Well, my mom actually made me go and get the belt, you know, in front of company, and that was really frustrating because once they made me take a bath in the front yard.
Why can't you be like everyone else and just remember the good things about the 60s?
Yeah, like Woodstock.
Oh, the Woodstock, great. Okay, no, Joel, you can't go to Woodstock. You're 9 years old. We're going to the opening of the new Century Store. Oh, yeah, on Echo Lane. 3 days of peace, love, and pizza rolls. We're going to buy you a shopping cart
Joel's
for your
in
birthday,
a lot of pain.
Joel. Oh, boy,
we'll be
Peter
right
from Axe moved freely among men. They were, did I mention there were drugs at that time?
Yeah.
And then... Yeah, and the only shoes they had were PF Flyers and Keds, and that was it. Nothing, no pumps, no nothing.
Okay, Joel, you can cool it now.
You okay?
Yeah. Hey, look at the prow on that steamer. Let's climb aboard. Whoa. Ahoy, matey.
Hello, Betty. Yeah, that's one of my chicks.
Turn to what?
The Comedy Channel.
Little promo there, gang.
Yahoo!
Hello.
Hiya, show.
Hello.
Wow.
Can we have breakfast at the club, dear?
That would be nice.
I wet myself. Ooh.
Thank goodness this briefcase is a personal flotation device. I love that trombone.
Welcome to White Island, acting like we deserve this kind of lifestyle.
Only the best-looking girls get to be starfish.
Chuck, it's great to have you home.
Hey, it's great to see you. What's your name?
Hi. Want to trade hair?
Sure made the scene out there.
It's all your fault. You weren't supposed to be here until tomorrow.
We finished our exams and split a day early.
Hey, how are things in the fatherland?
Hung up on the mainland for a couple days.
Your mom got hung up on the tennis pro at the club.
It must be Don Pringle.
You named it right, Miss Bunny.
I understand your ruffles have ridges.
Chuck mentioned you were coming in his last letter. We'll try to make your summer as eventful as possible.
Oh, wow.
Well, I'm prepared to defend myself against anything you might have said about me, if I have to.
He said you were a jerk.
Something tells me apologies are in order, Miss Bunny.
Miss Bunny. Now, Mikhail, what the hell are you doing?
That guy looks like Ralph on Green Acres, doesn't he?
Are you folks all right? Oh, yes, sure, we're fine. Fine, all except my assistant. He's a little wet. I left him on board.
I'm awfully sorry. That was pretty stupid of me.
Oh, think nothing of it, young lady. Those
you are blonde, after
I'm
all.
I'm Arthur Duval. This is my wife, Anne, our son, Tad.
Charlie Mott. My sister, Tina, and this
Tad
is
Tad Gene. Tad Tom. Tad Tom. Paul.
Bob Carroll. Tad Alice.
Stop that.
Isn't that the Sloan's yacht you're using?
Yes, matter of fact, it is.
Oh, the Sloans. We met the Sloans in Monte Carlo last season. Charming people.
Oh, they lie so gracefully.
Spend the summer here at Catalina, they insisted that we have the use of their yacht.
Yeah. Is this your first trip here?
Well, yes. We haven't had much opportunity to visit your little treasure island. However, we are interested in learning all there is to know about treasure, aren't we, Anne?
Hey, I just became a Mormon.
I'm with you, Miss Bunny. Dad, why don't you come along? We're going to split with the boat for some scuba diving.
Oh, but of course. Oh, that's a very kind invitation. Tad's been cooped up aboard ship since we arrived.
Tied to a mast.
Give you a chance to enjoy yourself, son. Meet some people your own age, like Miss Bunny here.
Get away from your effeminate father.
Man. Live a little.
No thanks. Next time around?
Not nearly enough beautiful women for me.
Dad, could I see you for a minute?
Certainly, son.
Excuse me, dear. I'm going up to the hotel to get another sun hat.
You know, Dad, Mom's really hot.
Dad, why did we come to Catalina?
Came to enjoy ourselves. Why?
Whenever you and Mother come to enjoy yourselves, it means you're involved in some kind of a shady deal.
Oh, I know you've been hanging around with that Dave Delgado guy.
To the quick. I'm glad your mother isn't here to listen.
When you talk like that, I know you're up to no good.
And when you smell like that, somebody must die.
What kind of a shady deal could we possibly be involved in on a small island like this?
I don't know. But whatever it is, you and Mother are right smack in the middle of it.
Ted, I give you my word. Your mother and I are here on a holiday, and for no other reason.
Yeah.
Now I'm starved. Let's get something to eat.
Yeah, and when you give that take to the camera, what do you expect?
Oh, my Dad, I love him so.
Uh-oh, hold it, you guys. This is going to be funny.
Yeah.
Now, just let it play out. I want to get all the great humor in it.
Get ready to laugh.
Great physical comedian of our time.
Heck of a walk from the mainland.
Oh.
And then it gets funny, right?
Oh, well.
Or maybe not.
Is that the funny part, Joel?
I guess.
This is the place. Okay, Miss Bunny, drop the anchor.
I already did.
Wow. Well, we need a new shower curtain.
What's the imagination?
I don't have one.
Ever do any diving,
Don? Oh, yeah.
University.
Not quite, thanks. There's a trick to it. Just remember one thing.
You'll be underwater.
Breathe normally, but through your mouth, not your nose.
Bottoms up.
He's always saying that. We don't know why.
Hey, it looks like a gas.
You'd better use the ladder.
Oxygen.
I'm on the diving team, remember?
Congratulations. Now use the ladder.
But I said I was on the diving team.
It's the Pueblo.
So I just keys. Very interesting.
But stupid.
What is it, Mr. Lacopolis? Let me have a look. Don't get excited, Barman. Too young for you. That isn't fair. You keep your mind on the business. I'll take care of everything else.
An exchange student.
I contacted Duval.
Now, Barbara, buff my head.
Unfortunately, Duval is a thief. A clever one. Remember that. But trust no one and be very careful.
And remember something else, too. An object in motion tends to stay in motion unless acted upon by an unbalanced force. Now get out.
He is also my only
sister. Doesn't sound very Greek, does he?
And a very stupid one. You, the purported art expert, I can replace.
Okay, Daddy Warbucks.
This, friend Borman, I promise you a long walk home.
Then I'll kill you again.
Should I go put the horse's head in my bed again?
Hi, Kaiser Wilhelm, you kooky monarch.
Macopolis is still out there.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Is that your hand?
You know, I'd give a month's pay to know why he's got such a sudden interest in California water.
$5?
Sure must be nice. Have all that bread. Cruise around the world on your own yacht.
Eat all the fruit, throw away the rind.
He'll die in the ocean, and when he does, those vultures that work for him will pick his little world clean.
Hmm. Nice analogy. I know I hired you for something, Rod McEwen.
Let's break for chat.
Take a watch for a while. I'll see you later.
They are a couple of salty tars.
What'll I do now?
Well,
Put on your face mask.
Hold on your what?
Can you breathe all right?
I can't breathe.
Now duck under and swim around. Stay close to the surface.
Wow, this is the weirdest Lamaze class I've ever seen.
It's all blue and sweat
okay,
and stuff.
You want to cough out while you're still ahead?
My nose does. It won't stop breathing.
Let's try it again. Take a couple of deep breaths through your mouth.
Oh, that's this thing, right? The slit in my face? Yeah.
But not if this time in 2 minutes. Fake it without me.
Ready
fake
to
it?
Give it a try?
Mm-hmm. I'm with you.
Hang on to my waist.
Anything you say, teacher.
Hey.
You've got the wrong sport.
When does it become the right sport?
When ESPN merges with the Playboy Channel. Now get underwater!
Remember, breathe through your mouth.
Not through your hands.
By this time, my... That was me. I'm sorry.
Make some Jacques Cousteau jokes instead, will you?
Say, I hear Ivan Tor is casting a new adventure show in the Keys with a dolphin.
What happens if I see a Leviathan?
You won't pay full price. Get the trip.
Time to impress some people. Then I'll go out and start a line of clothes called Polo. Oh, I look like Phil Harris, don't I?
I know this Borman guy.
He'll cast us an Excalibur.
He's got to know about killing and things like that. Oh, he's got it up here. Do you know that he knows the batting average of every White Stocking player of the 1876 season?
Oh, shut up.
Somebody had to check the painting, but in broad daylight and so soon. Oh, boy. I should have stayed in real estate.
Yeah.
Oh, that's my watch. It does that every quarter hour.
Cast off.
Oh, it hurts when I think.
Cast
Let's
off
see.
The line, idiot.
Oh, the line, yeah, right. The rabbit goes around the hole, and then it comes out the other, but it... Oh.
Meanwhile, on Bruce Wayne's stately yacht... Yacht, pardon me.
Hey, there's a boat out there. You think that's him?
No, that's us, you fool. Yeah. It's an exterior shot.
If you ask me, we're sticking our necks way out playing ball in his park.
You don't even have a
How
neck.
How come we gotta show the real Sproul to Lacopolis, man?
One thing you must learn, Lawrence, is that you show the genuine item to bait the hook. Proving to the buyer that you have it is one of the distasteful but necessary things about this business.
Tell me when you're done.
Maybe he won't show up anyway.
Borman specified the cove away from the harbor for the rendezvous. I doubt that he'll miss it.
Now, get away from me, little man.
Patience, Lawrence. One other thing that you must learn. Now, drop anchor.
Oh, there's that watch of mine again.
Where?
When you get out of here.
Okay, all right. Remember
great.
That last time?
Uh-huh.
We were a little disappointed. Yeah. I think now we're going to see a scene that's ripe with comic possibilities, all right? The real mechanics of comedy. Tragedy tomorrow,
comedy tonight.
Yeah.
The Jacques Tati of the boating world.
Yep.
I'm ready.
Sir Hulot in Catalina.
You know it's going to be funny. He's wearing corduroy.
Right. Going to get doused.
This is the funny right here.
Yep, he's going to catch his foot in the rope, right? Oh, no. Number 27, the old boat and the anchor trick.
But where's the funny?
Oh. Hey! Didn't come out of his tuck in time. Russian judge gives him a 3.
Funny at all.
That was kind of stupid, actually. Well, I'm the bad guy. Remember the meeting?
Andy Graham.
I am death.
Have you ever read our Watchtower?
On time, eh, gentlemen? Where's the scroll?
Bring the money?
Mr. Lacopolis is not a stupid man.
Sure, he drools and sings camp songs.
We'll arrange a fair exchange.
Gee, it's hard to take him seriously in that suit.
Yeah. You're soaking in it.
So, you swim around here much? Were you a little hard on the fat guy?
Yeah.
Don't you have a line? Oh, here he is.
Look, the water fuzz!
Water fuzz?
Yet some call them water pig.
Oh, no, you don't.
Oh, yes, I do.
Oh. There it goes.
You goes.
Please, love me. Oh.
Huh? What?
Spinner, paddle foot, quick, clutch is in trouble.
How did you like it down there?
Rude. Once they get the hang of it, I may give up the desert and rattlesnakes for life.
Yeah.
Water fuzz, they're wet, they care. Tonight's episode, Death Ahoy.
Yo-ho-ho and a bottle of death.
Tinker, tailor, soldier, dead man.
Michael, roll your murder ashore.
Hallelujah. No, Timmy, no, no, darn fool kid.
Skippy's in trouble.
Oh, no. You just ate. Be careful
shouldn't
down
be
there.
Well, they're gone. Let's form a girl group.
Maybe.
Oh, looks like somebody swabbed the deck with somebody's butt.
Dun, 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 dun. Long about that time, the old Duke boys got a little trouble coming their way. In the form of Mr. Skinman.
Huh?
It is cold now. Oh, just...
Hi.
Greetings. I come from the...
Hello?
Come on, come on. Get out here, baby.
Colors. Look at the colors.
Let's get back to Rylos 5.
This must be Wet Side Story.
Join me in my dance of death.
Yes, it's synchronized swimming on ESPN. The Wet Network.
I'm coming, baby boy! Here he comes! I'm swimming my little legs off!
I'm going to give you such a water wedgie, you're not going to ever forget it.
An aqueous snuggie.
I can't believe he did that. I just came over to say hello. What would make a guy do with that?
Here, breathe from me. Take life from me. Please.
Oh, look, they're standing four abreast.
Oh, please.
I'm sorry.
Oh, we'll just stand here because they're men and we're not. We don't want
to. Take him to the other boat! It's closer!
If it's so close, why can't we see it in this shot?
We don't want to be involved.
Gee, what a wimp. Can't even take a seasoned diver with a knife.
Boy.
I'm afraid you boys will find only evil here.
I had him, Jolly. I'm telling you, I could have killed him. But he took my thumb, Jolly.
What happened?
Well, I'm not sure. Well, I started in theater, moved on to summer stock, and now I'm in this film. Why?
He pulled a gun on me, and he took my wallet, and I tried to stop him, and we scuffled, and he went overboard.
He didn't have any wallet when I saw him.
It was eel skin. Happy now,
well,
prune boy?
Well, it doesn't matter. You see, there was nothing of importance in the wallet.
You see, because I'm lying my socks off.
No, never.
Where'd he come from?
Probably swam out from shore, I guess. Ah,
sure, yeah, that's it, that's right.
Yeah, sure.
I'm kind of skeptical.
Hey.
Seems like an awful long ways to swim just for a few dollars.
Yeah.
Last time I saw him, he was heading out to sea.
How would you know? You were drowning.
Well, it doesn't really matter. It's all over now, and I'm very grateful this young man didn't get hurt. Come on, Tiger, we'd better...
Don't call me that here, Bunny, please.
Tanks.
Jeez.
I tried to.
Real one out here, he knows! Just struck out.
Larry, will you please settle down?
Get married, have some kids, and take that ridiculous hat off.
We're concerned with a problem at hand. We've got to get that case back before Lacopola sends his divers back for it. Now, I know the scroll case is watertight, but if we lose it, we really strike out.
Think that's funny, huh? Shoot yourself in the leg. I'll be right back.
All done throwing up, Spunky?
Why worry, a girl?
I didn't know you cared.
I don't.
We're gonna get a bigger boat, right?
Yacht party date on such short notice.
Yacht party?
You're really nowhere. Haven't you ever heard of one?
Is it anything like a rattlesnake hunt?
What the heck does that mean?
I thought you were getting an education
we gotta
in
split.
Arizona.
Yeah, well, kids just beat me up a lot when I was a kid.
Really?
Yeah. No, the movie.
Oh.
You do have a lot to learn. They swing. Really swing.
Creepy girl. Oh, creepy girl, little creepy girl.
Jeez, what's wrong, Tom Servo? You look as upset and downtrodden as a little robot with inarticulate limbs can look.
Oh, it's creepy girl, Joel. I just met a girl named Creepy Girl, and suddenly I find...
I smell a song coming on.
Oh, creepy girl, Lyle Wagner's a total jerk. Second only to Tommy Kirk. Could you find it in your heart to love a bot like me? That fishy story you tell always makes me sleepy. But that's just what I get for dating a girl that's creepy, my creepy girl. Oh, C is for that feeling of uncertainty for not quite knowing what ethnic group you're from. R is for the gifts you give me every time you smile. The first E is for, well, I don't really know, but the second E is really a grammatical thing, because otherwise it would be creepy girl, and where would that leave us? The P is definitely not for platonic. And why? Because I love you, my creepy girl. Oh, what are you, creepy girl? Are you French, Italian, or one of those swarthy gypsy types? Well, your accent suggests a romance language, but I can't be sure. Oh, we can definitely rule out a Germanic language. But it's okay, I'm a bot without a country. All I know is that I love you. I want to shout it from the mountaintops. But I'd have to get back down to Earth and actually climb a mountain. Or they could just drop me off on a mountain. I don't care. That would be okay, because I just need you, my creepy girl. Won't you be mine? I'll give you scrolls and fish and tinker toys and wine. I'll ditch these guys if you'll be my creepy girl. Be mine before movie sign.
Got a Rorschach swimsuit.
What do you see in it, Crow?
I see the creepy girl.
Oh. I see cookie pants.
I see trouble.
Come on and do the dork.
Hey, nice little boat they landed there. They killed it. They're gonna roast it later. Buddy, get down.
Ouch, owie, oh, hot, pure, hot, still hot wood nails. Owie, staples, ouch. Well, this is the movie that, one of the movies that shaped Middle America's sexuality. Deformed.
Deformed, yeah. I could say something else, but I won't. It's cold out there.
This is a place.
Hell.
They call this a mirage.
They call it drug-induced hysteria.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Yeah, that guy must have something.
Yeah, he doesn't shop at members only or wards.
Well, when in Rome.
Yeah.
Or Athens.
What does that mean?
I don't know.
Hi, Charlie. It's been a long, cold winter, Charlie.
What does that mean?
Yeah.
Get over there. I need some more chicks.
What'd you say your name was? Yeah, I'm casting Caligula this summer, so come on
this
down.
This film was funded by the Utah Film Board.
Hey, she's got a shaggy diaper that leaks.
Get it away from me.
Hey, it's Ed Begley Jr. Hi, Kiba. Hop, hi, hop.
Hey, she lost the bone in her neck. Look at that flopping around like that.
Come on. Keep them coming. Monkey love pile on me.
That must be what they mean by five easy pieces.
Oh, please.
It looks like the cast of Zoom. Come on and
zoom,
zoom,
zoom, zoom, zoom.
Come on and zoom. Hey.
Zoom, zoom, zoom.
Nice tablecloth there, huh?
Yeah. Very practical.
Ooh, 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 ooh.
My posse. Oh boy.
Joel, was this before cocoa butter?
Yeah, I think so.
Sure, it's by the Renaissance Festival. And King John, who invites you to come down and see Robin Hood and Little John, two never-was actors performing bad skits.
And bad music. These guys are horrible. I'm gonna quit this band and start a career in music.
A couple of cheese eaters there, yeah.
Oh, please.
Bee Gees go bad. Or
worse.
And I haven't learned the words to say. Hey, look, I'm 60. I'm still rocking. Watch me.
Tune in, turn on, throw up. Ugh.
Now I know why drugs were so big in the 60s. You need them.
I won't pretend to sing.
To sing.
To sing.
To sing.
While the girls prance around in their BBDs. What do you think?
Yeah.
Pretty bad.
You know,
lyrics by Aldous Huxley.
And most of these lyrics are in it.
I think they sent the wrong people to Nam, Joel.
Yeah.
You know, could somebody do us a favor and push that guy's amp in the water, maybe?
We can't sing.
Can't sing.
There's a concept, it's called harmony.
Oh, look at those stupid legs. They're stupid looking. They're not real looking at all.
Look like puppets.
Huh?
Vig Heil.
Hey, anybody who wants, let's split to the beach for volleyball.
Go ahead. That's okay.
Hey, looking up. Look, we're picking up the sports channel.
Darn, and I forgot my shins. Woo, woo, woo.
Oh, the other kids hate me.
Yeah. 1 Adam 12, see the man whose shins were stolen?
Should have been on board the scuba party. You missed all the action.
I heard what happened. I wanted to say thanks for helping Dad.
I had to see the man. See the man, corner Wilmot and Carly.
Away. That doesn't matter. I appreciate what you did.
Yeah. I'll let you use my shins. Thanks. Deal?
Wow. Okay. Hey, what'd I do?
Oh, Joel, it's her.
Who's that?
It's a creepy girl, Joel. Oh.
Finally, a sultry woman with a nice body. It's about time.
Yeah. Swimming in threads like that.
Watch what you're talking about, girl. It's my girl.
Come on, follow the leader.
She's
none too happy. Mm-hmm.
Dibs. I call dibs. She's mine. Back off, you clowns. Get out of here. I'll take y'all out.
Let's try walking like her.
Hey. Oh, slow burn coming up.
Are you coming, Don, or not?
Well, you'll do nicely. Let's go have little Marty Milner's.
Remember what I said about the last man on Earth? Well, it's time.
Are you unattached like I am?
You mean from reality?
Yes, why?
You don't catch on very fast, do you?
What do you mean?
I'm afraid I'm not used to the speed.
Oh. Hmm. Don't tell me you're a drag, too.
No, there's just a drag queen. Mardi Gras here.
Think you can handle the beach party?
I think it's worth a try.
Okay, let's go.
What about him?
You're not engaged.
Hmm. Okay.
Loose morals, huh? I get it.
Meanwhile, on ESPN.
Everybody ditched the little guy.
So the game's over, huh? Hey, come back here. Hey, what's the matter with me, huh? Bad breath or something?
I guess I'm kind of messed up after all. Nobody likes me.
There she is.
What do you see, Tom?
Is she okay? I'm going out to get her, Joel. Quick, how do I get her?
Well,
I gotta.
Oh, no. Stand there and watch me die of pneumonia?
Well, both, actually.
No. I'll help you. I can't help her, Joel.
Gee, what a nice guy.
Excuse me, can I have my... where are you going? I'm sorry, I'm going to need that back. Excuse me, don't go too far with that. It's my windbreaker. I paid $5 for that at Ward's. Please.
Can I help?
No, thank you. Turn around.
Oh, thank you, God.
He's kind of caught between a rock and a hard place.
Don?
Sorry. I didn't mean to embarrass you.
Isn't this movie enough?
Well, this is no time to be delicate. It's a good thing you stayed behind. I was ready to sacrifice my modesty.
We'll get to that, my
love. I found out my suit is not for swimming.
Oh, Joel, I have a question. What happened to the treasure hunt part of the film?
Well, the movie's only half over. Maybe we'll learn something about it.
Don't keep your little fish.
Oh, you remembered.
Oh, yeah, your deep-seated psychosis, of course.
We talked on the boat. That is, I should say I talked. But we never really met. I'm Katrina Cavelli.
And I'm Cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs.
Nice to meet you, Don.
So you're here on an outpatient basis. I like that.
Huh? Your friends certainly know how to enjoy themselves.
They're a fun group. They sure know how to get their kicks.
Why aren't you with him?
Well, I don't know how to get my kicks.
See you again.
Is that why you stay?
Yeah, something like that.
Like with my little fish, I was afraid I wasn't going to see you again. I'm glad I was wrong.
Join us.
Join the party and people rules the world.
How about it?
Well, I'm kind of cooped out about that little fish and everything. It's all hot and it hurts and stuff.
His name is Angelo.
He's a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle.
He has something very important to do. And he's probably looking for me right now. He told me to wait down at the pier.
Where?
Oh, he said something about take a long, short walk on a long pier?
Something like that.
It's a dysfunctional relationship.
I'd like to thank you.
I'd like to thank the producers and the directors, too.
Has he been gone long?
No, not very. Don, would you like to help me look for him?
I'll help you. I'll help you.
Down this way.
So, did you call Harry Callahan yet?
I'll need 3 more expert divers by this time tomorrow.
And 2 implants.
You leave that up to me. What are we diving for?
That's none of your business.
Well, how do we know when we found it?
You to dive, not to ask questions. You'd better get out of here.
Like this?
Like that. Now I'm going to go polish my suit. There she is again.
You sure he came down here?
Yes. He said he had to meet a man on the beach.
Oh, that means he has to go to the bathroom. It's a guy thing.
Yeah.
Well, I think I better go back and wait for him. Angela has such a bad temper.
Angela Dundee.
Trina! You dig this, Angelo?
We're going to be married.
Not what I asked you.
You dig him.
I'm 1,000 feet tall.
Katrina! Why didn't you wait like I told you to?
Oh, you were gone so long.
You still should have waited. She was worried. And you keep out of this. Hey, kill him, man. You look in trouble.
Don, please. Let me take care of this.
All right, but if you run any static, just yell.
Just yell. Call for the turtle boy.
Yeah.
You were very rude, Angelo.
You had no right to be on the beach with a stranger.
Angelo! Something is very wrong. Who is this man who pays you for doing nothing and those men you always with?
Oh, he's from paid programming. This carbonet thing isn't going to last
That's
forever,
none of your
you know.
Concern. I never should have brought you here in the first place.
I should have brought
Perhaps
Vicky Lawrence.
You're right, Angela.
What is that?
Let me settle this right here and now.
All right, I'm all for it. Hey, but we ran... Hey!
Whack.
Hmm.
Okay, now, Joel, how do we comment on this without getting into big trouble?
You could use metaphor, maybe.
Raspberry red.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I read my mind.
Choo choo choo.
I just saw your sister.
Oh.
Oh, I'm tired.
Quick, get a pin down his throat. Drake him.
He's tired from all that makeout.
Well, I don't even have an agent. I just saw the ad in the trade dailies, and here I am.
Hey, clam bake.
Fade out, man.
Fade out.
Who's minding the store?
Jerry Lewis.
The Harbor Patrol has an afternoon off. Where'd you split to? Felt like cutting out for a while.
Hmm.
You tried that one
jargon.
On my sister.
What are they talking?
She was hung up with another guy.
Hi, Bob.
Hi, Net Girl.
You like this, dude?
Yet.
Lyle.
Don't you dare speak to me.
Okay.
Wow!
It's her again. It's creepy girl.
Oh,
forget it.
Oh, I can't. I just can't.
Hi, lower life forms.
Hello, Don. I've decided to accept your invitation.
To the beheading?
If it's still open.
Why is it? Sam, you've got to be the mother of all pigeons.
Yeah, tell him to stop messing up our statues.
Don't mind him. He's got a language all his own.
Yeah, he took a shell in
now. Aren't you going to introduce me to your playmate, Don?
Katrina, this is everybody.
Miss January, this is everybody. This is this.
Katrina, that was real dandy sport. Hmm? I'm Charlie Moss.
I collect custom showgirls.
But you can forget about him. He's ready for a wheelchair.
Hey, come on, I'm 17. Cut out the good-natured ribbon.
Her if nobody will introduce us.
Meet the daughter of Satan.
I gotta change my drift net.
Did I say something wrong?
Where's Angelo?
I don't know. I don't really care.
Because of me?
That and the man named Lakopoulos.
What about Lokopoulos?
He'll thrash you from top to bottom.
Doing what?
Diving, I think. That's about the only thing Andrew's ever done. Why?
Could that be the diver you tangled with?
I dare not tell them that they speak to my
family.
Some other
guy. Who's Lakopoulos?
I'll close
one
up his esophagus.
Then you know of his reputation.
I'm afraid we do. I wonder why Lakopoulos needs a diver.
I saw it on Ted Coppolis.
Help!
A baby's cry for help.
Help!
Help! Help! Help! My career is drowning.
Hang on, I'm coming!
Wait, I'll get my jack. No, I don't.
I'll stay here and protect the harem.
Boy, he's so funny in the act of tragedy. Oh, something horrible.
Oh, there he goes. Oh, wait, he's got salvage rights.
What was that? You who cried? Keep your butt above water, that's good.
Nice. It's better than that tarpon I caught in Demon. This is a keeper. I'm gonna get out my fillet knife.
Surfing turf, man.
You betcha.
Saved by the stinky guy.
She almost died.
She almost died.
She's got water in her lungs. Brain damage.
That's for you, Mo and Larry. Spin his shins.
And if she was drowning, they would have all gone in.
Unite!
Crazy
Popper! Crazy Popper! The slap happiest game ever.
Hey, how did
you get slapped? Get him, girls. He hit Buddy. Like a strange version of Lysistrata.
The chicks are up in arms. They've left their fields and barns. They're marching in the barns because kids won't drink enough milk.
I will.
You're a jet all the way. Hey, there ain't nothing like a day. You got something in the sand.
Nothing looks like a dame. Nothing looks. Well, this must be on the way to the Greenwich Village Halloween party. I'm thinking.
I hope I get it. I really hope I get it.
For some inexplicable reason, a deep-seated call from nature causes these lemmings to follow each other off the edge of the high cliff.
Man, I got a pole with a capital O.
Woo-hoo! Is he a time traveler?
And now Red in the silent spot. Red's a fisherman and... Uh-oh.
too small. I have to throw it back.
She hit Big Jake.
I feel a number coming on.
Hey, we better do something, but quick.
Yeah, let's do something.
Hey, it's Gloria Esteban and the Catalina Deus Ex sound machine.
Hey, gang. Maybe if you do this, it'll be okay. Ready? Five, six, seven, eight.
He's the only professional dancer they hired, so they gotta use him.
Cassie!
Is that Danny Terrio?
Yeah, he's the guy who taught John Travolta to dance.
Girls just can't resist the frolicking vibes of a hot guy. Neither can I. The body on him.
Girls begin to become aroused by the provocative gyrations of the shamed males of the village.
That's a... You know, I still am having a hard time figuring out what this has to do with any scroll.
I don't know.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, gang, let's gather around for the next scene.
Hey, it's the same shot as before. I love that.
Nobody gets it on this one.
Wow, they're dancing for apartheid.
Yeah, it's to raise money for the National Front.
It's the Keep Mandela in Prison dance.
Right.
They want to play Sun City, I guess.
E.W. Botha, back in office.
Ah, the clean smell of kids who know they rule the world.
Grab that place, will you?
Oh.
Too bad. Mm-hmm. Next time. I'm getting done. Oh, sounds like the tape's getting eaten here.
Oops.
Oh.
Eight-track. You want to tie that up over there, Servo?
I'm trying to bite it there. My arms don't work. Darn.
And her name is Sybil.
All her friends. Hey, this is great. You know, now that she's so famous, it's fun to see these old clips. Huh?
Yeah.
From her humble origins, she went on to
obscurity.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is a way to see. Boogie.
Hey, they grew up to be Jim and Tammy Baker.
Let's not have talent, let's do away with fun. Let's all be wise, really wise, snowy wise.
Hey, I checked out the Book of Love one time, and it was really hard to find in the library because there's not a lot of copies of it. There's just notes in the margins and the pages. Huh?
Just watch the movie, okay?
And we're all wise, and we swing to the right.
Oh, wow. Carmine Ragusa again.
Hey.
Uh-oh.
Hiya, show.
Hey, do the jerk. The idiot. The moron.
The potato up the bump dance. The dick queen.
Do the white male reality. The Donald Hollinger.
Yeah. Do the back row.
Yee-hoo.
It's just one big, sunny, fun-filled baton death march.
Don't rewrite anything.
We never change. Why should we? We're on top of the world. White love.
It's good, isn't it? Tell me it's good. Come on.
It's exciting.
Why did the Titanic have to sink and this didn't?
I don't know. You know what the difference is between the Titanic and this?
What?
Titanic had talent.
Oh.
Thank you! Thank you! You've been a great crowd, Catalina! Tip your waitresses! Good night, everybody! Oh.
Oh, boy.
Oh, the old... old suitcase gag. Little this is a classic.
Suitcase and, huh? Oh,
see?
No.
Yes. That's so funny.
This guy makes the film for me.
He makes a film for me, too, but it's...
Not this one, huh?
No.
Okay, let's can it. Platt's back now.
A pasty film on the...
The youth of today spent like so many shell casings on the battlefield of love.
Now remember, I'll do all the talking.
And you do the interpretive dance.
Good man. Well, good morning, everyone.
It was.
I forgot.
Hi, Mr. Duval. Oh, what a lovely day for basking in the sun.
What are you doing here, Dad?
I just thought I'd take my morning constitution.
Oh, here on the beach?
At 2 p.m.
Can't fool you, can I, son?
No, but I've got a feeling you're going to try.
Well, the truth of the matter is I'm here for a reason. Yeah. You see, I'd like to do something to put a little zing in the weekend for you kids.
Might give you some bennies, yellow jackets, or goofballs.
What do you have in mind, Dad?
How about a scuba diving party?
Scuba parties are nothing new.
Not the one I have.
Nitrous oxide in the
tanks. I want you and your friends aboard my yacht by 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. How does that sound?
Wild.
Yeah.
And you'll be diving for lost treasures. Yeah. Items worth $5 and up. And here is the grand prize.
It's a stick of dynamite.
What is it?
You get to throw it at
it. Oh, it's an old map case.
Now, for every one of these you
throw
prime,
it over the side
you donate a penny to Jerry's care.
And the diver who brings this up wins the grand prize and $100.
$100?
Wow. I could do with $100.
Yeah, nothing check wrong with out. Her, $100.
Don't forget, on board by 10 o'clock.
And don't forget your plot device.
Dad, I've got that funny feeling again.
Take an aspirin, son.
Take a whole pot.
Okay, I'm with you so far, but I'll be watching you, Dad.
Good boy.
He's not even my son, you know. He's Marty Milner's kid.
Well, the rest is up to them now. They don't come up with that stroll. You can bet what topless divers will.
Oh, Flag,
you bring the other things to drop overboard.
There's no way that guy can make sense.
You can talk now, stupid.
Oh,
never mind. Let's get back
to the phone.
He's a comic genius.
I don't see him.
The U.S. in Dolphins Harbor, the Exxon Valdez.
They should be coming up soon.
What, our lunch?
Dining for over an hour, and there's no case.
Patience, Lawrence. Patience.
Lawrence.
Hey, everybody, I found a new script, and this one's funny.
Well, there's bobby pins down there and band-aids, and there's a lot of hair on the drain.
What do they got?
That we ain't got.
Courage!
Next, divers.
That's the third time they pop with this thing.
And our time's
see
running
time
out.
Fly.
Charlie Sheen in Navy SEALs, a Golden Globus production.
Hey, it's us again.
Arthur, I have a splendid idea. Why don't they all go down together for one final effort?
Without tanks.
Sound idea. Is that agreeable with everyone?
Yeah.
Very agreeable. Thanks for asking. Appreciate it. Mm-hmm.
We are here to spoil everything.
Over there.
Hmm? You must be after the scroll. You see any other divers?
Only
no,
you.
Maybe they found it. We can't afford to guess. Let's find out.
What, down here? Oh, okay.
This should be great.
Oh, this is bad.
Huh?
Look, it's Dino, Desi, and Billy.
Hey, Sinatra got him a gig.
At the bottom of the harbor. He must be tripping.
Huh? Yeah, so. Entertain all those other guys at the bottom of the harbor.
The couple should have made his move by now.
Yeah, well, I guess they figured we were just...
Oh, I got sandwiches. Oh, wait, I got that pistol from the man from Glad.
I really know how to handle guys like that.
How? Oh.
You got me.
Where is it?
You're a very sneaky man.
Oh, I'm with you.
I don't have time to fool around. Where's the scroll? Should we give him three guesses?
I don't see why we should.
Oh, don't make him mad.
We gotta stop, guys.
I can't watch this.
Come
on. Oh, they look tough. Yeah. I think it's his sarcasm sequencer. So I'm gonna have to field strip you, little buddy. Come
hey,
here.
Ow! Hey, that hurt. Give me that
hey,
back.
Hey, neat. I'd like a wing, please.
The overlords are calling. Look sharp, you guys.
Oh, hi, Joel. Just thought you'd like to see what we got going on down here. I think you know everybody. This is Jerry, and that's Sylvia, and you know Joel and the bot. So let's get started. And oh, Jerry, you haven't even touched your sandwich. It's good stuff. And Sylvia, coffee. Just all you want, free refills. Free refills. Anyway, we're gonna have a lot of fun. So let's get started. We've got fun, easy to plan stuff here. Now, Sylvia, back me up on, you know what I'm talking about, this one. Are you with me on this? These guns that are stored underwater, this method with the baggie and the, it makes no sense. It's totally impractical. It's just outmoded stuff. We have nothing to do. But this product, that I'm giving you the opportunity to get in on here. It's a triple ply polycarbonate reinforced substrate. As a matter of fact, it's the type of material used by the astronauts on It's About Time. It's
well,
about
Fred. Fred, how's our new venture
Frank.
Going?
Frank.
Oh, whatever.
Oh, well, it's.
Don't mind me, I'm just going to sit in and observe.
Okay.
Go on with your presentation.
Oh. Okay, good. You get some of that. I think we got some Wisconsin. Yeah. Cheese lock. There. It's not the same thing with him. Okay, we got, this is for storing hand grenades. This is perfect. It fits on, and we have the gel in it. It stores at 3. And look, it fits perfectly. It's okay, and we have the this salad. It's fruit salad stays perfectly well. Never would. Oh, well, here, let me just stick, put that there. And this is even better here. This will stay right on there. There's no. Stick that up there with the thing, and we'll put the. Oh, maybe I should do a joke. You ever notice how the mole men with the thing and the. With the, put the
Frank,
huh?
Frank,
huh?
Why don't you just pack it all in here? It's okay. Why don't we just start cleaning up? I give you points for your little party here, but
you're gonna hurt me, aren't you?
No, Frank. I give you a.
You're gonna be mean to me.
No, I'm not. Why do you pull away?
You're gonna be mean. You're gonna hurt me, and it's gonna be humiliating. It's gonna hurt and stuff.
Look, Frank. You've got a lot to learn about being a mad scientist, and you know, I think I'll buy one of your melon ballers.
Actually, there's some melon right up there. That'll be
Frank! Frank's going to be having a little pain. We'll be right back.
Karate pinky.
I got the empire.
Get out of here.
This will launch my empire.
I know. King Dex, man.
Oh, tell your friends, dude.
Oh, Blackwater, keep on rolling.
Any resemblance to a real action sequence is purely coincidental.
Once you get caught between the moon and New York City.
Did they get the case?
Oh, yes. I saw them take it away from
They
Charlie.
Took my thumbs. They. Oh,
no, wait. They're still here.
The other day. What's in that case? Whatever it was, it sure must have been worth a lot of bread.
I knew you were up to something. I want to know. What's it all about?
Alfie.
Fighting?
I'd like an explanation, too, Mr. Duval. I mean, this is the second time in the last few days that I almost got myself killed.
Yeah, lots of other
Maybe
stuff, too.
Maybe if you take us back to Avalon, son, I'll explain a little later.
Will you put your hands down, Lawrence?
No, I don't want to play
well,
patty cake.
We really shouldn't feel too badly. The fates were against us.
And it cost us $500,000. Oh. Boy, the ball games I could have seen with that girl.
I hope they
you know,
don't trace
I don't
the
think I
want to
live in a world
us.
Filled with adults
not
anymore.
Not a chance. Nothing's right. You're hurting. Real.
Yeah, so that's what I'm afraid of.
And there's always the chance of the police tracing the stolen scroll back to my folks.
Are you sure this is the real scroll?
Hey, who's to say what's real and what's not real, man?
And besides, we heard Dad talking about it.
We can thank the screenwriter for that.
More than a few hours. The scroll we thought we were diving for was a phony. I just got a flash.
A hot flash?
When those cats find out they've got the wrong merchandise, man, they're gonna be out for blood.
And everything's coming down on me today.
Let's unload this hot potato on the fuzz.
Cool it. Get the fuzz into this and his folks end up in jail.
I can't use this lingo
Bob's
anymore.
Bob's already suspicious, especially of Acropolis.
He's totally psychiatrist.
Your old man wants it so bad. Be my guest. I haven't got the blood to spare for those vultures.
Got the hair for it.
That's no good. The minute Dad gets it back, the temptation will be too much for him.
And the four taps and the
spins. $500,000 is too much for him to turn down.
For my bread, you should have left it where you threw it instead of going back to die for it
later.
Please,
I implore you. Shut up.
I have no right to say this.
God, your hair
smells
good.
But I think I know
good.
A way to... Well, to scare the larceny out of your folks once and for all.
Scare the what?
And get Angelo and Borman arrested. I'm ready to try anything as long as it doesn't involve Mother and Dad with the police.
Or farm animals.
We know they want the real scroll. What we've got to do is make sure that they know that we've got it.
I'm not about to have them take out their frustrations on me.
Shut up!
How about, Charlie?
And lose my image?
What image?
What's the play?
It's 12th night.
We try and smoke out Angelo and Borman.
12th night?
Bound to be around someplace. Let's find Tina and some of the kids.
These kids today with their loud music and hula hoops, fax machine, I don't know. For those of you following along in the Sitfield screenplay workbook, that last scene was the plot point setting up the third act. Now this.
Mayberry, after hours.
No shirt, no shoes, no script.
Okay, hello mother, hello father, here I am at Catalina. That's not right.
Zach Norman is Sammy and Chief Zabu.
It's the big guy.
I have to sit like this since the implant.
I'm watching you, Cranhead.
Nothing. Here come the bunnies. Maybe they did better.
Hopping down the bunny trail.
Hey, it's Charlie Angels. Plus a smart one.
Nobody. At least not anybody who looks like the two you fought on the Lyra.
Keep looking. Move out, troops.
Well, it's McMillan and wife and wife and wife.
Can I talk to you a minute?
What?
Talk. Just a minute.
We gotta go. What's wrong?
About yesterday. I'm sorry I slapped you. And I wasn't really drowning either.
Oh, yeah, and I'm not
I forgot
acting.
All about that.
Really?
Really? But you do pack a pretty mean wallet.
Don't rub it in.
I was gonna say for a pretty girl.
But you're ugly.
Listen, Charlie Moss has got a groovy sister. You know who else thinks so?
The football team?
Tad.
Well, I apologize to him, too. Only first. It's them!
Go find Charlie, quick.
Right now.
Hey, Charlie. I'll take him on. I know I can. I'll do it. Yeah. I will.
Lucky open table.
How come he got a menu already?
Oh, peach daiquiri. So that's what I drank last night. Tasted pretty good.
Nice spit take, dude.
We've got to get the scroll.
I'm still waiting for my spinach omelet.
And no slip up this time.
Hi.
Yes, I am. Hi. You?
I've been looking for you.
Creepy girl.
Don't make any heroic moves, my friend.
It's too late to rewrite the script.
Hand it over.
Angela, what are you doing here?
Work and be an evil.
Friend, I don't have time for games.
And I haven't got time for the pain.
Angelo!
Man, everybody's coming down on Angelo.
Thank you.
After him, team gang.
You had jet, you're a jet all the way.
Splendid, son.
It's a Catalina Army knife.
Always be prepared.
And a feminine.
We'll take care of the garbage. Go get them, Don. Can you handle this one, Mr. Duval?
It's Landfill.
Oh, sure I can.
Some call them Landfill.
You bunny, stay here. See what he calls your master away.
Hmm? What do you mean by that? Okay, people, everybody wear eye protection. There's a lot of loose ends flying together all at once here.
Wow, this Main Street USA parade is really getting thin.
Hi, folks.
That's not Mickey, that's Nicky.
Hey, he's running into the Haunted Mansion.
Ooh.
I knew a ghost host.
Don't snag on me, don't snag on me.
Eat it, boy, eat it.
Oh, no, 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 Jerry, Jerry, no. You got me all wet, boy.
Well, I guess he's swimming back to Greece. You're late, aren't you, buddy?
Take a rest, friend. You've provided enough comic relief. Thank you, Corky the Water Clown, for making us laugh at love. Again.
What do you think you're doing?
I've got you this time, Duval. Will you take these silly things off my wrist?
I'm the silly thing.
It's a long time for you to make a slip. Nah. Now I've got you. What's this all about? Who are you? Fingers O'Toole, insurance
FBI,
investigator.
Craft
this man
division.
Is my prisoner.
And what's the charge?
Grand theft.
And wearing an ascot.
You don't even know what you're talking about.
You stole the scroll from the collection, and it's in that case you're holding.
Oh, wow, he's
Give me
holding,
the case.
Dude.
Hey, cool, a Bon Jovi poster.
Kind of like a peace shooter, isn't it?
Good one.
It's gone.
Baseball.
My career.
It was in there. I know it was in there.
Why me? Why me all the time?
Where did it go? I don't believe it.
I'm Iggy Pop.
Oh, boy. Yeah, the script's in Braille now. He looks about 40.
Closing time, young fella.
The guy who lives here wants to go to bed.
Sure is beautiful. Yes, sure is.
Man, I sure love that old snot rag of a...
Huh? Huh?
So, you know, win them all.
The pain.
I lose a rich one, gain another.
Stealing eyes.
Win one, lose one. Famous American cliché.
Shaving my head.
I told you it would be a long walk.
Didn't I tell you that?
Enjoy.
You can destroy manly robot monster.
Kill him. Kill him.
Musical newspaper from Japan. And look. Zach Norman is Sammy and Chief Sabu. Says right there. Oh, yikes.
Let's quit. I'm hemorrhaging.
Hey, Mom, Dad, you got any rhythm left? We're out.
How did it get out of my case back into the museum?
We'll figure.
As Charles would say, don't knock it, Dad. Perhaps it's best forgotten anyway. Acropolis has sailed away forever. Perhaps a little bit wiser for his experience.
I doubt it.
There's only one answer, Ann. Somebody up there likes her.
No, dear. I think someone loves her.
Well, it's not me.
Well, what now? What's left for us? Not
drug
one
running?
Single prospect on the entire island.
Prostitution?
I've searched high and low. The pigeons have all flown
Slumlords?
Away.
Slumlords?
Well, you could always go to work.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Work?
As Charles might say, that's a boss idea. You know it's time I did some retiring?
Well, there's that Louie Nye look-alike contest. Good dance, Goofy.
Good enough. Oh, I've outgrown this pratfall stuff. It was just a phase. Now I'm a swinging cat. Yeah.
Hey, it's a skinhead. Get Geraldo.
Say.
Oh, look at creepy girl. Doesn't she look great in a hairdo like that? I like her in a flip.
Oh, he's down to one girl, huh? He's cutting back. Oh, nobody wants to dance with a big, stinky guy.
Sure, it's louder than the music, isn't
yeah.
it?
Dirt Shack.
Dirt Shack, baby.
Yeah. That's what it says.
Got a movie that's as long as a whale.
It's about to set sail.
A plot hole that's as big as a whale.
Huzzah! King John invites you to the Ren Festival. Come see 300 years crammed in one place. Meet the people you snagged on in high school. Bring your own tights or wear some of our own.
Principals to the front, please. Extras in back. There you go. Thank you.
Oh, it was only a movie.
What? Oh, it wasn't real? Oh, it was real, too.
Wait, I'm having some trouble here.
It was right in the middle of that.
Brother.
So, a good movie deserves a good encore of the cast.
I wonder if we're going to see the fish again here at the end.
What fish? Oh, that's right.
Fish from the beginning?
Yeah. And the scroll, that was good.
I still don't really get it.
We got to do something to understand this. This was just bizarre.
It's something to do with a lot of foreign films with a lot of subtitles.
Where did the scroll go to and how did it get back where it was?
It was a lot easier to... This is harder than a Werner Herzog film to figure out.
I think it's important that we experienced it together. Don't you? And we shared.
Yeah.
We better get out of here.
Let's go. AMF vomit?
Carry me.
Oh, that's
no.
voice.
Please? Come on.
Man, that was really confusing movie, wasn't it?
Well, no, not really. I only have one question, actually.
What's that, girl?
What the Sam Hill was going on?
Yeah.
Well, which part of the movie did you have a hard time with?
Well, I was doing okay until the opening credits ended, and then I thought it was like a cartoon with really good animation.
You know, I'm confused, too. The only thing that made any sense to me was that darling creepy girl. I can't seem to get her out of my mind.
Tom. Stop the music. Cambot, cut it out.
Oh, sorry.
Very good, Mr. Tommy Servo tune there. I had a feeling this was going to happen with this. So on the way back from the theater on the spiral on down, will you move over, you guys?
Excuse me.
I took the liberty of making this chart of the film, okay, so we could figure it out a lot better.
Neat.
Yeah, great. Thank you, you spinach chins. Anyway, this is going to make us all feel better, so... Let me just start explaining it, and we can help each other. Okay, Act One. The Alan Sherman wannabe in the Crayola hat, that's this guy down here, steals the scroll from Pegboard Mansion. Okay, Tom?
And he hands it off to the Louis Nye guy, the Billy DeWolf wannabe with the Jim Backus mouth, and the Upgrade Wife aboard the thinnest ship in the Navy.
Oh, I remember now. Upgrade Wife drew a fake of it, which they planned to pawn off on Mr. Vanopolis.
Yeah.
Okay, Slam Dance Cosmopolis.
Yeah, do the Worm Acropolis.
Would you two stopolis?
Okay, now, then, Lockjaw, Jim Backus, and Crayola Head here get in a big plastic hassle with Lyle Wagner, and the script or the scroll ends up going south.
Hold on, Joel. You're getting way ahead of yourself. What about Tommy Kirk meeting the creepy girl on the boat and the sensitive soliloquy about the little fishy?
Wait a minute. You're both forgetting to mention that all the singing and dancing with Little Richard tripped up on goofballs.
Okay, what the heck did that have to do with anything? The entire plot was hinged on the relationship between the creepy girl and Tommy Kirk.
No, listen, the whole emotional thrust of the second act was when Lockjaw throws the hullabaloo cum treasure hunt to get the scroll back in his possession.
What about the dysfunctional relationship that the kid who looked like Jim Baker, you know, shared with Billy DeWolf and Jane Bennett? I thought that was the emotional center of the film.
If anything, Crow, that was the emotional tootsie center of the film. Man, I'm teed off.
Fair.
I'm gonna go get the letters.
Joel, the letters right here on the desk. Shame it.
Okay,
all
right.
Read that letter, will you?
Try to calm down.
Come on now.
Okay. Oh, this is great. I'm sorry I got kind of crazy there, but...
so am I.
Okay, this is a really neat letter. Let's put it up on the screen there, Cambot. It says, Dear Joel, Tom Servo, Gypsy Cambot, and of course, Crow, we think you... This may be a first for your show. We met, we spent time together, and fell in love watching MST3000, and now we're getting married.
That's wonderful.
We're hoping you can make it to the nuptial festivities, but if the evil scientists won't let you guys off, please send a picture of Crow for us to keep and cherish
fabulous.
As a precious reminder. Tell Crow the door is ajar. Okay.
And
here, put this up, Cambot. Here's the wedding announcement. We're going to have to block out some of this so
we
don't get a bunch of misties there.
Yeah.
But anyway, I thought
New York.
Yeah.
Is it an open bar?
I think that was super cute, cool, and really romantic.
Yeah, isn't romance wonderful? Yeah. Hit it, Cambot. Creepy girl, oh creepy girl, my eyes pour out to you in heaves and droves of iridescent shapes and stars through the sky, but I don't care, creepy girl. I got hit in the head with a crowbar and I just don't see straight anymore. All I know is I love you.
Bad movie. A good fruit salad. Push the button, Martha Stewart.
Never, ever, 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 ever.